Welcome to the Fox 17 Rockin' Review on the web. I'm hanging out with Mr. Stacy Mitchart, and I really appreciate you coming in this morning. Stacy, you know, known you for a long time. You know, you're you've played around Nashville since the 90s, you know, or before.
Yeah, 96,
and,
yeah.
And you brought in some great gear today. You brought in, you know, one of your Epiphones, and you are endorsed by Epiphone. You've been playing them for 8 or 9 years since I saw you in the full-page ad. And so what guitar did you bring with you today?
This is the reissue of the 1961 Casino. It's a they only made 1961 of them.
Wow.
And so it's out of their custom shop. I think this is somewhere around 1473 or something. But it's, I mean, just even the regular casinos are, because I have a couple of those, and they
right.
match up pretty daggone close.
I totally agree. I think they sound and play great, and I think they're a great value for people when they're looking
oh,
for
yeah.
instruments,
yeah,
you know,
definitely.
Guitars, and maybe you don't have the money for the next level of a Gibson.
Well, you know, Epiphone has a great history. Originally, Epiphone was the premier guitar over Gibson.
Oh, yeah.
And through the years, it kind of switched around. But, I mean, they're really bringing them back. And, I mean, this is a super great instrument. I put it up against Eddie Gibson.
Well, I mean, it sounds great in your hands anyway.
Thank you.
You know, and then also you brought some pedals in with you. And you and I were talking, as so many of us, you know, when we're, you know, you tour all over the country, up into Canada, you know, you've got your Canadian Blues Award this year and all this. So you're traveling all the time, and this is actually your latest pedal board.
Yeah, and it's freaking people out. They're like, what is that stuff, man?
So if you water these, they come out to full-size pedals, right?
Yeah, right, like a chia pet. But no, I mean, it's real simple. I've got a tuner, just kind of a warm boost thing.
Yeah.
Your regular distortion pedal.
And these are the mower pedals here that are the
yeah.
smaller ones. And like you said, they're, you know, very cost-effective.
Yeah,
and they don't take
up
much room.
Yeah, get them up at Superior Music
yeah.
in Mount Juliet.
Well, and I didn't even know, you know, you had this pedal train Nano hooked to your gig bag, you know, with your guitar, and
yeah,
I didn't even know it was on there.
Yeah, it's got a little bag, and you just put it around the neck part of your gig bag, and
wow.
so you're carrying your whole deal. It's great.
Well, then also, you know, when people see you out at gigs or see you around town in Nashville, you've got some CDs out right now.
You buy.
And right there you have it. You know, mm-hmm. I think my favorite is Live from B.B. King's.
That's the latest one. It did really
and,
well.
And that's the last place I saw you play. And people can find these, you know, on your website.
StacyMitchart.com.
Very
Two
cool.
Two H's in Mitchart.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
But they'll find it anyway, yeah.
Awesome. Well, then, also I wanted to talk about, you brought in some vintage gear too, Stacy.
Yeah, old
and,
stuff.
And man, you've got some great gear. And you brought in, if we could take a shot of it, one of your old Gibson Scout amplifiers.
Yeah, that's a 1962. And I found it locally here at Fanny's Music over in East Nashville.
And it sounds great.
And man, I use this in the studio because I just love it. It has, again, simplicity, man. It's got an on-off knob and then loudness, reverberation, and tremolo. You gotta love it.
And it's very warm. And then the guitar sitting next to it is a pawn shop prize, one of the old K's
yeah.
that actually has the toaster pickup.
Yeah,
and it still has the vintage pennies underneath the bridge.
Yeah, I'm afraid to take them off to see what year they are. But no, I found it at a pawn shop in Cincinnati, in my hometown, for $60. And I've been looking at it. It's probably worth about $1,200 now.
Oh, my gosh. And, yeah, what a great example.
I use it for slide in the studio. I take it out every once in a while on the gig. But it's a great guitar. And if you set it up to play like a regular guitar, it's a nice little jazz
yeah.
piece.
Beautiful, beautiful guitar. Well, I appreciate you coming out and hanging out, bringing in some of your vintage gear, bringing out your Epiphones, and of course your small pedals, which do the job on the road.
You got to get these things, man. They're great. Everybody's going, ow.
Yeah, I was talking to Dexter at Rock Block, and he was like, yeah, man, I'm getting a lot of calls on them. So the new latest fad, right?
Well, it's easy.
Yeah, exactly.
Small, light, old.
You know what? And it's also easy to go to Stacy's site and check out where he's touring around town and check out his CDs and
Facebook too, of course.
Right? So come and check out the band, right?
Definitely.
Awesome. And thank you for checking out the Fox 17 Rockin' Review.